That brings us to the conclusion of this course. We've covered a lot of useful and interesting information, but before we sign off, let's review the bullet points from all the sections and together build an infographic that can act as a guide for us when we work with these models. Let's get started. We started with a typical bolted joint and the role of a bolt in this assembly. We have learned the taxonomy of the bolt and nut assembly, followed by its mechanics. When a bolt is tightened, the mating parts apply forces on the bolt head and the nut, and this creates a state of pretension in the bolt shank. In finite element analysis, this behavior is modeled by splitting the bolt shank into two halves, connecting them using MPCs, and then pulling them towards each other to mimic the state of tension. In Ansys Mechanical, this type of load is defined using bolt pretension object. The user has to scope it to the bolt shank, define preload in the first load step, and then set it to lock in subsequent steps, and the rest is taken care of. A few things to remember. Under preload, the bolt is in a state of pre-stress, and this increases the overall stiffness of the assembly. In fact, this is the reason why tightening the bolts reduces the vibration in the machinery. The state of pre-stress created by the bolt preload is captured using a static analysis. Such an analysis may be followed by a multi-step static analysis that applies the operational loads to the bolted assembly. It's also common to see a transient or a linear dynamic analysis run afterwards to study the structure's dynamic characteristics. In either case, the presence of bolt preload changes the stiffness of the structure, and this change is captured by the stress stiffening matrix. When we proceed from a static analysis that captures bolt preload to the subsequent analysis, we must always log the bolt to maintain this preloaded state. Otherwise, the preload effects are not accounted for in subsequent analysis. Therefore, remember to load and lock. Bolts can be modeled using either solid or beam elements, and the bolt preload can be defined on both. Solid elements are computationally more expensive, but they provide an accurate representation of stresses developed in and around the bolt and allow for modeling of more complex interactions between bolt and mating parts, such as with frictional contact. Beam elements are not as expensive as solid elements, and therefore they are very efficient in modeling bolts, especially when they are present in a large number in assemblies. They do provide details about stresses developed in and around the bolt, but these results are not as accurate and detailed as solid elements. Bolts transfer the preload to the rest of the assembly via connections that transfer forces between them. In case of solid elements, contacts take this role of connections, where threaded joints are replaced by bonded contacts, and interactions between the bolt head and other parts is typically captured using frictional contacts. In case of beam elements, Ansys Mechanical offers beam connections, which allows users to create bolts as beam elements that are connecting the two mating parts. The beam nodes are connected to mating parts using MPCs. If the bolt is modeled as a line body, then one can either use a fixed joint or an MPC bonded contact to connect the line vertices to the mating parts.
There, we have our infographic. And that brings us to the end of this video too. You're now prepared to develop models for preloaded bolted joints. Good luck and model responsibly.